terms of traffic, drivers should avoid I-695 Southeast Corridor and use I-95 and I-895 as alternatives. I-695 is being detoured southbound at exit 43, the Peninsula Expressway, and northbound at exit 2, Route 10. Vessel traffic into and out of the Port of Baltimore is suspended until further notice, but the port is still open for truck transactions. Obviously, we're very thankful for the first responders who are carrying out their efforts in these rescues, and that they're doing this all through the night and today, and we're praying, obviously, for everyone's safe return. We'll continue to provide updates to you, the next one being approximately 9:30. With that, I will turn it over to Lieutenant Colonel Palmer from the U.S. Coast Guard.
Good morning. My name is Lieutenant Commander Aaron Palmer from Coast Guard Sector Maryland National Capital Region. I'm the current Acting Chief of Response for the sector. The Coast Guard's primary mission right now is search and rescue, looking for any survivors in the water. On scene, we currently have 3 small boats. We also have a Coast Guard Tower Mako, an 87-foot patrol boat. We have a helicopter from Air Station Atlantic City, and we're working with numerous federal, state, and local partners on scene on the search and rescue efforts. Thank you.
You going to take any questions at this time?
What role is the FBI playing in the investigation?
FBI has basically to see if there's any terrorism connection, which there is not.
Any confirmed deaths?
No confirmed fatalities.
Any recovered from the water alive?
It's still under, still the rescue mission is still active.
Do you have any sense of what happened to the actual cargo ship? There were some reports that it suffered some major power outages just before it crashed into the bridge.
Too early in the investigation.
Was a pilot operating the ship coming in and out of the port? Was it a port authorized pilot, or was it the captain of the ship?
No,
the
pilots move ships in and out of the port.
What's happening?
Pilots move ships in and out of the
port. What's happening to all the other ships that are waiting to back up? How are you navigating that?
Basically, we're communicating with them. They obviously understand the situation, and we'll deal with the logistics of that.
Has the crew been evacuated from the ship, and
that's all being done right now. I don't know the exact details of where they all are.
Well, obviously, is the FBI involved? Is this being investigated as suspicious?
In any type of incident like this, the FBI would be engaged, just to make sure, and that's what we do.
And you have any idea how many vehicles are in the water? Any idea how could this happen? This bridge
too early.
Should not collapse like this.
Too early investigation.
Okay,
how long will the port be closed?
Do you know how deep the water is there and sort of this area where it happened, the conditions?
Approximately 50 feet. 50 feet.
Can you give an update on how many people were rescued, how many were pulled from the water, how many are still searching for?
That is what we're doing. We're basically searching for everyone that was potentially on the bridge. As you can imagine, it's the middle of the night. You know what type of traffic was there? How many workers were there? Workers, they obviously come to a project, but other workers show up sometimes. So that's what we're investigating right now.
Is this unprecedented? Is there anything like this ever happened?
Not in Baltimore.
Sir, can you talk more about the workers on the bridge, what was going on, and how many vehicles you think might actually be in the water?
There were, they were basically doing some concrete deck repair. We don't have the number.
Do we know who they work for?
I don't have that right off hand.
How long will the port be closed, in the estimate?
Are you still looking for 7 people?
A number of people, that's the one number that we've had, but obviously we're researching to see if anyone else was on that bridge.
Can you speak to some of the challenges with the water, the current, the darkness this morning?
All of the above, to be frank. A very, very tough situation. 1 a.m. in the morning, very little information at the time. It happened instantaneously, as you've seen.
There has been a number of hours at this point. What can you tell family members who might be watching about any hope that you will still recover survivors?
We actually have set up a facility for any family members. We have health professionals there as well. So there's a,
and are you ruling out any kind of intentional motive?
We don't see anything that relates to that at this time. It's an open investigation, but there's nothing that looks that direction.
First calls after the incident come in directly from the ship. When the
ship to get there. Who were the first ones to make the 911 call to kind of alert
you? I don't know. I don't have that information.
Do you have any indication of whether the ship lost power?
It's too early.
Just clarification. Last question, please. Port is closed except for trucks moving transport out.
Right.
This bridge was built in the 1970s. I'm so sorry. This bridge was built in the 1970s. It took about 5 years to construct it, right? Any idea what we can expect moving forward? I mean, the bridge is...
Too early. Obviously, we reached out to a number of engineering companies. So, obviously, we have a long road before this thing. Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you.